In this machine learning tutorial, we will look into what is k nearest neighbor classification. We'll go over some theory, then we'll write Python code, we'll build a model, and then you will have an exercise to work on. Let's say you are doing a classification for iris flowers. Here I have a picture of versicolor flower, which is one of the three types. And based on a sepal width and height, you can actually figure out which of the three flowers category it is in. So we are classifying an iris flower into one of the three classes, setosa, versicolor, virginica, based on sepal width and height. You can plot sepal width and height in this kind of 2D scatter plot, and you can plot all your data points, you know, all the data points for which you know what is the class. Now, let's say you have built a model and you have a new data point. So yellow data point, you don't know what class this is. And using KNN, you want to figure out. By looking at the graph itself, you immediately get an intuition that this has to be blue color, which is virginica, because it is more near to this cluster. And KNN works just like that. In KNN, you first figure out what is the value of my k. And you can figure out the value of k by trial and error. There is just no like specific rule to it. Usually people use 5, but you know, you can change it. So let's say here I use k is equal to 3. And this means I need to figure out the most nearby 3 data points. So the most nearby 3 data point using Euclidean distance, which is just a simple distance between these two points, are these 3. And since these 3 are virginica, my yellow data point is also virginica. K nearest algorithm, nearest neighbor algorithm is super simple. You figure out the most nearby K data point, and whichever data point category that data point belongs, my new data point belongs to that category. Let's say my k is 10. Again, you figure out the most nearby 10 data points. So here I have 7 virginica, 2 versicolor. You take the highest number, which is 7, which is virginica. How about if k is 20? Well, then you have a problem, because your total number of data point in virginica class are very less. So now it is misclassifying this yellow data point, saying that this is versicolor, because the rule is you figure out the most nearby k data point and you take the maximum count. So here k is 20, so maximum data points which are near are versicolor, which is 11 data points. See, 11, 7, 2, 11, maximum number. But this will be wrong, because clearly by looking at the graph, you know that this yellow data point is actually virginica. So you have to carefully choose a value of k such that it's not very high or not very low. Again, it's trial and error, depends on your situation, depends on your training data set, and so on. Let's write Python code now. One thing I would like to clarify is that here we had only two features, sepal width and sepal height, but KNN works equally if there are more than two features. You know, there could be n number of features and KNN will just work fine. I mean, as a human, we can't visualize it, but mathematically it should just work okay. We're going to use same iris data, flower data set for our coding. If you go to YouTube and search for support vector machine Python, I have this SVM video in which I used iris flower data set. So I'm going to use some of this same code here. So if you go here and look at the code, and if you have followed this video, you would already be familiar with this code. So I will use the same code till the point that I create a classifier. So same code is here. Basically, you are loading iris dataset from sklearn datasets. Then obviously the feature names are sepal width and length, petal width and length. Sepal and petal are two different flower leaves, like the components of the flower, and based on these four features, we determine whether it's a setosa, versicolor, or virginica. So our target classes are 3. I have loaded iris.data in a data frame, And then I'm adding a new column called target in the same data frame. So you see now my data frame has five columns. Four are my features. The fifth one is my target. Basically, zero means Setosa, one means versicolor, two means Virginica. This code, my friends, is very, very easy. If you have followed my SVM video, you would have no time understanding this. You need to have some knowledge of pandas as well. Now, if I do df target equal to one, it will show me all the versicolor flowers. And you see they start from the index 50. If I do two, which is all Virginica flowers, they start from 100. So basically, I have 150 training samples, out of which first 50 are Setosa, 50 to 100 is versicolor, 100 to 150 is Virginica. And I'm going to split this main data frame into three data frame. So when I do nothing colon 50, df0 will have all Setosa flower, df1 will have all versicolor flower, and df2 will have all Virginica flowers. And I'm using matplotlib to do some plotting. I have a scatter plot of sepal width and length between df0, which is Setosa, df1, which is versicolor. So these are the two kind of clusters that we have. And looking at all these clusters, we get immediate intuition that we can apply KNN classifier here. All right. And I'm doing train test split, usual thing. If you have followed my videos, you would know what this is. So we are dividing our samples into training and test data set, and training set now has 120 samples. Test set has 30 data sample. All right, now comes the most interesting part, which is creating a K nearest neighbor classifier. Google is your friend. You probably all know that. In that, specify sklearn KNN classifier. You will get scikit-learn documentation. This is how you create KNN classifier in scikit-learn. And usually they give a nice little example at the bottom. So I'm just going to use my most important skill, which is Control C, Control V, and create a KNN classifier. So I would say KNN classifier. Okay. What are the parameters in the classifier? Obvious one is neighbors. This is basically the value of K. So I'm just going with, you know, three. And there are other values. You can read the documentation. I'm going to keep everything else default. This is a beginner tutorial. But metric Minkowski, what is that? Let's read. So metric. So Minkowski means it's basically your, if P is 2 and metric is Minkowski, it is using Euclidean distance. Okay, so where is here? Okay, so see, read this. It is going to use your standard Euclidean distance for computing the nearby neighbors. You can use some other distance as well, and this parameter can control that. I'm just going to use whatever is the default and simply call knn.fit method. So I created KNN classifier. Call KNN fit on X train and Y train. And my classifier is trained already. And first thing I do usually after training my classifier is compute the score. So when you compute the score, you're giving X test. So using the more train model, it will find out the prediction. And then it will compare that with Y test. And it will tell you how accurate is your model. My model is so much accurate. See? It got all prediction right. You can maybe change this value. I mean, 3 is ideal, but I'm just changing the value just for fun. And see, with different value of K, you get different score. So whenever you are using KNN, try to figure out best value of K for your use case. You can use grid search CV or k-fold cross validation to figure out the optimal value of n neighbors. For us, the optimal value is 3, but I am going to keep it 10 so that, you know, we can see some variation in our confusion matrix. So in the previous videos, we have already plotted confusion matrix. So confusion matrix tells you for which classes it got the prediction right, for which classes it did not get the prediction right. So to plot it, you will import confusion matrix from sklearn matrix library. And then what you do is you use knn for making prediction. So you give x test, you find y predicted, and then in confusion matrix, there are two parameters. First is truth and second one is prediction. Okay, what is my prediction? Prediction is this. What is my truth? Truth is y test. And there you get the confusion matrix. Now, if you don't know how to read it properly, basically this is your confusion matrix, but for better visualization, we can use a seaborn library. We have used it in previous videos, so I'm not going to go over this code in detail, but it's the same exact grid. You are just having a little better visualization. Anything on the diagonal are your correct prediction. This means this 0 is Setosa, this 0 is Setosa, and this is truth, this is prediction. What this is saying is 11 times it was Setosa and my model predicted it to be Setosa. So this diagonal is all correct prediction. Anything that is on not on this diagonal is wrong prediction. So one time what happened was truth was versicolor and it said it is virginica. You see, 2 means virginica, 1 means versicolor, and this one is how many instances. So we totally did, how many predictions did we do in total? 30. So 12 and 1 13, 13 and 6 19, 19 and 11 30, because we have total 30 samples in our test data set. And out of those 30, only one time it got the prediction wrong. Remaining 29 times it got it right, and hence the score is so high. You can also use confusion matrix. So not confusion matrix, the classification report. So from sklearn matrix, you can import classification report, and this classification report takes your y test and y predicted. And you know, okay, the formatting is not great, so if you put print statement, it's gonna show you a little better result. And this is showing you precision recall FN score for each of the classes, this one class, two class, and so on. So you have to get your fundamentals clear on precision and recall. And if you go to YouTube, search for code basics precision recall, you'll find my video. If you watch it, you will get an idea on all these parameters. So that's all pretty much that I had for this video. KNN again is a very simple classifier, very, very easy to understand. If I explain it to high school students, they will also understand it easily. The code you saw was so simple, 3 lines. It's like freaking simple classifier. So after you watch this video, you need to work on an exercise. So if you go to my GitHub page, I'm going to provide all these links in the video description below. Exercise.md has this exercise. And this exercise, friends, is the most important part of my tutorials, because learning coding or machine learning is like learning swimming. Until you practice, you're not going to get much benefit. So practice is extremely important. I want you to load digits dataset from sklearn and use KNN classifier to classify digits from 0 to 9. You also need to plot confusion matrix classification report like how we did it in the current video. Also for our main classifier, you need to find an optimal value of K that gives you the maximum score, either by trial and error, manually trying it out, or by using grid search CV. A good student would try on their own, and then only they will click on solution link. A bad student would directly click on solution link and try to look at the solution, but the downside is that they will get a virus which I have embedded, encrypted into this GitHub, and your computer will start sneezing and your computer will have a fever. So if you don't want your computer to have a fever, please try the solution on your own and then only click on solution link. All right. Thanks very much for watching. If you have any question, post in a comment box below.